In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it.
Children of the New World, descendants of the conqueror and conquered, offspring of Africa and Turtle Island, children of the crossing, of global waters of wind and red clay dirt, progeny of the peculiar institution of trade routes and commerce, we the collateral damage of empire. Children of Anakaona and Nzinga, seeds hidden in mother's braids, planted in new soil, roots buried deep, blended names, blended tongues, blended gods, summoned forth by the idea in the mind of an ancient. Cradled under ribcage and flesh for 280 days, listening to the electric fluttering of our mother's heart, listening to its incessant drum. That's why our rhythm is the weapon, and our medicine's a song, so we listen, and we love, and we dance on the one. Children of the diaspora, forged from miracle and sound, the B-side of a miracle, a syncopated song. Heirs of criminalized culture are we, heirs of the outlaw drum are we, concealed freedom in the djembe and juba, bambula, boogaloo, bachata, soca, and salsa is us, breakbeat, disco, house, and hip-hop is us, rumba, palo, merengue, makulele, but music to dance to, music to worship, music to call down, spirit is us, music for the spirit is us, music to live by, music we cry to, music we die to, music to love by, music to love by. Music to love by, that's why our rhythm is the weapon and our medicine's a song, cause we listen and we love and we dance on the one. That's why our rhythm is the weapon and our medicine's a song, cause we listen and we love and we dance on the one.
Choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.